Hey everybody, we just released a new tool called the Disavow Links tool, which lets you tell Google which links to your site you'd like to ignore. Let me give you a little bit of context, tell you about how it works, and basically fill you in on the background. So as Google has gotten better and better at assessing backlinks, there's some people who more or less want to clean up their backlinks. So maybe you've been doing paid links, or someone on your behalf has. You might have been doing blog spam, comment spam, forum spam, guestbook spam, you name it, link spam. Maybe you paid somebody to write some low quality articles and syndicate those all over the place with some very keyword rich anchor text. And maybe Google sent you a message that says, we've seen unnatural links to your site, or we've taken targeted action on some unnatural links to your site. And so as a result, you want to clean up those backlinks. Well, first and foremost, the main thing that we recommend is getting those links actually removed from the web. So, you know, if a random person looks up links to your site, you don't want to see a bunch of spammy links. So it's good to clean up for other purposes. You don't want them to jump to conclusions. It's also good so that other search engines won't sort of see spammy links to your site as well. So we do recommend that you write to people, try to get the link taken down, and basically get as many of those links as possible. Now, at the same time, we realize sometimes it's not possible to get in contact with everybody. So at the point where you have written to as many people as you can, multiple times, you've really tried hard to get in touch, and you've only been able to get, you know, some certain fraction of those links down, and there's still a small fraction of links left, that's where you can use our new tool called the Disavow Links tool. So how does it work? Well, first off, you need to figure out which links should I disavow. Hopefully you have a pretty good idea, but there's a couple ways you can take a whack at that. First, you can look at your recent links. So we will show you now, Google will let you download a list of links sorted by the date that we discovered them. So you can look at the most recent links if you might have just gotten a message or a warning about unnatural links. We're working on ways where when we provide links that we, you know, the unnatural links warning, will actually in the text of that message give you maybe one, maybe two, possibly up to three examples of the sorts of links that we're talking about. Now, this is not a comprehensive list. We're saying these are the sorts of links that we are trying to ignore, or that we don't count, or that we think looks low quality or spammy. And so the message does not mean remove these two or three links and now do a reconsideration request. It's to give you a flavor of the sorts of links, whether it's a low quality article bank thing that you were syndicating, or whether it's, you know, a paid link network or whatever, the sorts of links that we would like to see taken down. So how do you actually use the tool? How do you disavow links? It's actually pretty simple. We want to reiterate that most people do not need to use this tool. So there's been a little bit of brouhaha in the last few months where some people really want to clean up their backlinks, but if you're an average mom and pop, if you're just doing normal sorts of things, you're not doing really especially egregious or aggressive SEO with all kinds of weird link networks or stuff like that, this is not a tool that you should need to use under any sort of normal circumstances. So when you load up the tool, you'll hopefully see a lot of disclaimers that sort of remind you, under normal circumstances, you shouldn't need to use this. So only if you've gotten a message, if you really think there's an issue with your backlinks and you really want to clean it up, and you're a power user, you feel comfortable doing technical things. So the first version of the interface that we're launching sort of reflects that. It's basically the ability to upload a text file of links that you'd like to ignore. So my site, for example, is maccuts.com. Suppose I want to ignore a link from example.com/page.html. You simply make a text file that says example.com/page.html, and you upload that. And so the format is just one URL per line. And we tried to make it a little bit easy. So suppose you have a porn site, pornsite.com, and it links to you, and you want to ignore all links from that domain. You can say domain:pornsite.com. You can also have comments, you can have a little hash signs, you can like document, you know, your efforts to try to get links pulled down or provide some more context there. And then you just basically upload that text file. Now it's a single text file for a domain. So if you have multiple registered owners and you want to add or edit or update that file, we provide a way to download that file, and then you would be able to edit it. You can, you know, add another link to ignore, or, you know, anything along those lines. If you wanted to, you could empty that file out, and then you can re-upload that, and we will process that in turn. Now, how will Google actually treat it when you say, I'd like Google to ignore this link? we treat it as a very strong suggestion, but we don't treat it as something that we absolutely have to abide by. And before you get nervous or worried, that's the exact same methodology that we use for rel canonical. So we have seen some guys where they will have a website and they say, oh, I'm going to rel canonical over here, and that's a 404, and they can shoot themselves in the foot. So we do reserve the right to sort of look at things and say, oh, we think this is something that the user didn't intend to do. But in normal circumstances, we will take it as a very strong suggestion. And so basically treat it a lot like nofollow, sort of drop that link out of our processing. We do expect that it will take probably weeks once you upload your list of links to disavow for all of those links to be disavowed, because we have to recrawl those pages, re-index those pages, and reprocess them in order to sort of attach the attribute that says, okay, this link we would like to no longer treat with the same weight. We would like to treat it with zero weight. So it does take a fair amount of time. If you're doing a reconsideration request, I would explicitly mention, hey, I have disavowed links, just so that we can go and try to check up on that whenever the manual web spam team is investigating. The other thing I would say is, this is a power user tool. We don't want people to go overboard with this. Most people shouldn't need to use this. And so really only use it if you have good reason to think that you need to. In particular, somebody is sure to ask, well, what if I want to undisavow a link or reavow it? And the answer is that will take even longer. So I would say, once you disavow a link, make sure that it's a link that you really want to disavow, that you don't want to have it count anymore, because it will take a lot longer and we might not give it the same weight if we start to allow it to be reavowed. So only take a look at the links that we're either providing as examples or the links that you think are truly spammy, and those are the ones that you really want to disavow. So try as much as you can to clean things up beforehand, and then use the disavow tool afterwards if you feel comfortable. The last thing I would just want to reiterate, and I want to really get this across, most people should not need to use this. We build our algorithms and we look at our spam processing such that in most cases we handle things just fine. A very small number of people are getting these unnatural links warnings, and so proportional to the web, most people do not need to be using this tool. It's also an advanced tool, just like with rel canonical. You know, if you rel canonical to somewhere that doesn't exist, it is possible to shoot yourself in the foot. So be careful. Don't just, you know, go in willy-nilly and submit a ton of files and you're like, okay, I'm changing a whole bunch of stuff every single time. You really want to maybe do an audit of your backlinks and try to get an idea of the ones that look truly spammy, or the ones that, according to recent stuff, look like they are not links that they should count. And those are the links that you might want to think about disavowing. I realize even if I tell everybody this, there will still be a lot of people who just, you know, run for the disavow link tool. But again, whenever we're doing reconsideration requests, we are going to look at the set of links that existed before, and then we're going to be doing spot checks, and we're going to be looking at, you know, are those links off the web? So don't just immediately think disavow is the answer for all my ills. You're also going to want to try to remove stuff off the web first. And this is a power tool. It's something where it is possible, in the process of telling Google to ignore links to your site, to make mistakes. And so I would approach it with caution. I wouldn't just jump in. If you were a mom and pop, if you haven't used your own SEO, if you haven't used, you know, random link networks that you found on SEO forums, this is probably not something that you should be using. So I just want to try to reiterate that, and hopefully everybody can remind everybody else of that if people are talking about it on forums or, you know, conferences or whatever. But we are pretty excited to be able to offer this, because we do hear from SEOs who try to do cleanup, and there is an entire niche for people, for SEOs, whose job it is to clean up backlinks. And this is a tool in that arsenal after you've done all the other cleanup that you can do. So we're really happy that we are providing this option, and thanks for all the feedback for the people who asked for it. And let us know what you think of it, and then we'll continue to iterate and look at other ways to improve. Thanks.